Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Wednesday Night Prayer Meeting, a podcast about the history of jazz told from the perspective of someone who's been piecing it together one record at a time over the course of 20-odd years digging through record bins. I'm your host, Frank, and that was Man of Words from the album Out Front by Booker Little, a song that I opened one of the early episodes of Out There with that is so stunningly beautiful that I thought it only fitting to open this week's episode about Booker Little with it. Booker was born in Memphis in 1938 to a trombonist father and pianist mother. He started playing music at a young age, first on trombone, then clarinet, and then at the age of 14 was encouraged to focus on trumpet by his high school's band's director. At age 16, he moved to Chicago to study at the Chicago Music Conservatory, and while there he roomed with Sonny Rollins, who served as a mentor to him, emphasizing the importance of finding his own unique sound. Rollins, who had played with the Clifford Brown Max Roach Quartet, introduced Little to Roach, who soon offered Little the trumpet spot in his group left absent by Brown's untimely death. Little turned the offer down in order to complete his studies at the conservatory, but soon after finishing, joined Roach's band and began recording almost immediately. In 1959, he relocated to New York City and recorded a series of increasingly innovative records as a band leader, as a sideman, and co-leading a recording session and a series of dates at the Five Spot Club with Eric Dolphy. Sadly, Little had kidney troubles, and just 2 years after moving to New York, died of uremia. Even though he only lived to the age of 23 and was only active recording for 4 years, he left behind a body of diverse and innovative work. Coming up next is Call to Arms. Enjoy. Thank you. That was Sweet and Lovely, a Thelonious Monk tune from the album Booker Little 4 and Max Roach, with Booker on trumpet, Tommy Flanagan on piano, Art Davis on bass, and Max Roach on drums. Before that was The Confined Few from the album The Teddy Charles New Directions Quartet, with Booker Little on trumpet, Booker Irvin on tenor, Teddy Charles on vibes, Mal Waldron on piano, Addison Farmer on bass, and Ed Shaughnessy on drums. And starting that set off was Call to Arms from the album Third World by Donald Byrd and Booker Little, with Marcus Belgrave, Donald Byrd, and Booker Little on trumpets, Mal Waldron on piano, Addison Farmer on bass, Ed Shaughnessy on drums, and Armando Perazza on congas. Up next are a couple of longer pieces, the first of which is called Clip Walk. Enjoy.
We'll be right back. Thank you.
That was Ode to Charlie Parker from the album Far Cry by Booker Little and Eric Dolphy, with Booker on trumpet, Dolphy on flute, Jackie Byard on piano, Ron Carter on bass, and Roy Haynes on drums. And before that was Cliff Walk from the album Newport Rebels, with Booker Little on trumpet, Julian Priester on trombone, Walter Benton on tenor, Peck Morrison on bass, and Joe Jones on drums. Newport Rebels was credited to the Jazz Artists Guild and was a product of a protest that Charles Mingus organized against the Newport Jazz Festival on the grounds that the monolithic festival wasn't open enough to new directions in jazz and focused on exhibiting more commercial sounds. It was an example of a schism in jazz that was becoming more and more evident at the time. The most forward-thinking music was being ignored or discouraged by the music industry establishment, and critics grew more and more skeptical of the direction that the most advanced artists were taking. There's a famous interview that Leonard Feather conducted with Eric Dolphy, wherein Feather questions Dolphy's departure from traditional forms of music, his turning away from easily comprehensible chord and scalar bases of music, that called attention to an ever-growing incommensurability problem between jazz musicians and critics. In a 1961 interview in Downbeat magazine, Booker Little weighed in on the debate with his own harmonic theory. "I can't think in terms of wrong notes. In fact, I don't hear any notes as being wrong. It's a matter of knowing how to integrate the notes, if you must, how to resolve them. Because if you insist that this note or that note is wrong, I think you're thinking technically, conventionally, and forgetting about emotion. And I don't think that anyone would deny that more emotion can be reached or expressed outside of the conventional diatonic way of playing. I'm interested in putting sounds against sounds, and I'm interested in freedom also, which doesn't limit the soloist. In my own work, I'm particularly interested in the possibilities of dissonance. Coming up next is If I Should Lose You. Enjoy."
Thank you.
That was Strength and Sanity from the album Out Front by Booker Little, and I realized I didn't list the musicians earlier for the track that I played from that same album, so that's Booker Little on trumpet, Julian Priester on trombone, Eric Dolphy on alto, Don Friedman on piano, Ron Carter on bass, and Max Roach on drums. Before that was Black Fire from the album Sounds of the Inner City by Booker Little and Booker Irvin, with Booker Little on trumpet, Booker Irvin on tenor, Teddy Charles on vibes, Mal Waldron on piano, Addison Farmer on bass, and Ed Shaughnessy on drums. And starting that set off was If I Should Lose You from the album Booker Little and Friends, with Booker on trumpet, Don Friedman on piano, Reggie Workman on bass, and Pete LaRocca on drums. Thanks for listening. The long piece for tonight is called The Prophet, and it's from Live at the Five Spot with Booker Little on trumpet, Eric Dolphy on bass clarinet, Mal Waldron on piano, Richard Davis on bass, and Ed Blackwell on drums. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.